And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. The Canadian Grand Prix. The big controversy here, obviously, is the fact that I did not receive the penalty for the Gasly incident. By no means was it intentional. I was not trying to take him out of the race. Wasn't trying to do anything to hurt his chances of finishing this race. I thought I was clear to make that block to try to keep him behind me because I wanted the sixth place finish. Anyway, he was there enough that it turned me into the outside wall. And by the time I got it saved, I tried to get on the brakes, just went to the right wall, ripped the front wing off, somehow was able to get back out in front of him. Ricardo got around Gasly, and we were able to hold off Ricardo. I don't know how I walked away without a penalty. I'm not thrilled with that finish. Obviously, we finished sixth, which that I'm happy about. But I'm not happy about how we got it because I don't feel right about it. I feel like I really should have been penalized and finished
eighth. Good day today. Let's have your take on it. Not a good race for Lucas. How do you think he'll be feeling about not finishing?
We'll take it in stride.
Judging from today's race, it must be pretty hard to fend off Devon when he wants to pass.
I'm sure a lot of the drivers do find him hard to do.
You gained a lot of positions during the race, didn't you?
Yeah, the car's nimble, it's light, it has its advantages.
Things looked close between you and your rival for a bit, but you came out on top, didn't you?
Car is fantastic, and honestly, even though we're in the same team...
Appreciate your time.
Never had a chance. He's just a lesser driver. So, with disappointment in the way that it finished, we'll move on to Paul Ricard and France and try to be more clean and better off. Gonna try to get the upgrades that failed and maybe some more upgrades so we dive deeper into the different trees. Certainly we just got a little bit from beating our rival, George Russell, and of course also beating, or well, we're ahead of Lucas Weber, but yeah. Ooh. Very nice, very nice. Very nice.
That's a great result. You did really well. I don't think we can have any complaints with our performance.
You know, that middle one right there, talking about how I did better in the race than in qualifying, the first time he doesn't sound like an ass. Definitely want to get the engine back above Mercedes. I feel like that's big for us. So we've got three things coming, hopefully, for France. Two of them were failed, so they're guaranteed. One of them is not. Let's go ahead and take a look at what's coming up at the next race at Paul Ricard. And then what I've noticed is that after that race, there tends to sometimes be driver transfers. There it is, talking about myself being able to move to different teams. So we're on to Paul Ricard. Very fast track. This is a track that very well could benefit us again, much like Montreal did. So looking forward to this and hopefully another points-paying finish as we continue to prove why we are better than George Russell and why he deserves to disappear, at least in this career mode. We got three messages. Everything was completed, which is wonderful. And it looks like it's going to be a nice dry weekend. And let's see where we're at now. As you can see, we've actually jumped McLaren, too. Us and the Alpha are keeping pace, but we've jumped McLaren. We're right behind Racing Point, and we're just going to keep climbing. So certainly we're where we want to be. And with the engine package that we have, it gives us a much better time on these long straightaway circuits. So we'll see you next time for the French Grand Prix.